OpenAI just had its first dev day. This was a conference to announce new features and updates to ChatGPT. They announced some crazy new features, including things like the ability to create your own GPT, being able to post it on a new GPT marketplace and get paid for it, a new GPT-4 Turbo model, a new text-to-speech model with 6 AI voices, cheaper prices, and an assistance API, which can interact with your UI and applications on the fly. In this video, I'll be going over all of those updates and more. Let's jump right into it. So, the conference started out with a big announcement, a new GPT-4 model, GPT-4 Turbo.
Today, we are launching a new model, GPT-4 Turbo.
This model has 6 major improvements. The first is context length. GPT-4 Turbo has 128,000 tokens of context, which is 16 times the old GPT-4 model. The model is also much more accurate over a long context. The second thing is more control. This includes a thing called JSON mode, which will allow developers to force the model to respond with valid JSON. It's also better at function calling, which means less requests needed for the same response. Another big point in this category is reproducible outputs.
You can pass a seed parameter and it'll make the model return consistent outputs. This, of course, gives you a higher degree of control over model behavior. This rolls out in beta today.
If you've ever played Minecraft, you know that you can get the same world as someone else using a seed. With this new ChatGPT model, you can use seeds to get the same exact output as someone else. Number 3 is better world knowledge. You can bring outside knowledge from your own data source to ChatGPT. This means if you have documents stored in a database or huge amounts of data, you can either upload or link them to ChatGPT, and ChatGPT will ingest them and have knowledge about your new data. The knowledge cutoff is also being updated. GPT-4's knowledge about the world ends in September 2021, while GPT-4 Turbo will have knowledge up to April 2023.
And we will continue to improve that over time.
Number 4 is new modalities. DALLE 3, GPT-4 with vision, as well as text-to-speech is going into the API November 6th. An example of DALLE 3 use is Coca-Cola.
Today, Coke is launching a campaign that lets its customers generate Diwali cards using DALLE 3. And of course, our safety systems help developers protect their applications against misuse. Those tools are available in the API.
The API can accept images as inputs and can generate captions, classifications, and do analysis. The text-to-speech model is pretty crazy as well. OpenAI is introducing 6 AI voices that sound incredibly natural that will do text-to-speech. Listen to this one.
Did you know that Alexander Graham Bell, the eminent inventor, was enchanted by the world of sounds? His ingenious mind led to the creation of the graphophone, which etched sounds onto wax, making voices whisper through time.
This will help with language learning applications as well as language assistants. Number 5 is customization. Starting November 6th, you will be able to fine-tune GPT-4. For enterprise, they are launching custom models where their researchers will work closely with a company to develop a custom GPT model for their use case. That's probably going to be super expensive though. The last improvement for this model is higher rate limits. GPT-4 Turbo has its rate limits doubled, and you are now able to request these limit increases on the website itself. That's pretty cool because you don't have to email them just to get an increase. The next update for this model and previous models is the pricing. GPT-4 Turbo will cost 3 times less than GPT-4 for input tokens and 2 times less for output tokens. That turns out to be 1 cent for 1,000 input tokens and 3 cents for 1,000 output tokens. Pretty sick. After going over GPT-4 Turbo, OpenAI announced something called GPTs.
We're thrilled to introduce GPTs. GPTs are tailored versions of ChatGPT for a specific purpose. You can build a GPT, a customized version of ChatGPT, for almost anything, with instructions, expanded knowledge, and actions, and then you can publish it for others to use. And because they combine instructions, expanded knowledge, and actions, they can be more helpful to you. They can work better in many contexts, and they can give you better control.
This update is the first step for them towards creating agents, basically AI, where you ask the computer to do something, and it will do everything for you. A GPT is almost like a Discord bot, where you can build one and publish it to the GPT marketplace, and then get paid if people use it. I honestly wonder how much they are going to pay people, because this might be a valid way of making some extra money. This update is so cool. Anyways, here's an example of a GPT that he showed.
So, to start, GPT Builder asks me what I want to make. And I'm going to say, I want to help startup founders think through their business ideas and get advice. After the founder has gotten some advice, grill them on why they are not growing faster. And you can see here on the right in the preview mode that it's already starting to fill out the GPT, where it says what it does. It has some like ideas of additional questions that I could ask. And you know what? So it just generated a candidate. Of course, I could regenerate that or change it, but I sort of like that. So I will say, that's great. It's going to go figure out how to do that. And I would like to show you the configure tab. So you can see some of the things that were built out here as we were going by the builder itself. And you can see that there's capabilities here that I could enable. I could add custom actions. These are all fine to leave. I'm going to upload a file. So here is a lecture that I picked that I gave with some startup advice. And I'm going to add that here. In terms of these questions, this is a dumb one. The rest of those are reasonable. And like very much things founders often ask. I'm going to add one more thing to the instructions here, which is be concise and constructive with feedback. Now it's going to look at that document I uploaded. It'll also have, of course, all of the background knowledge of GPT-4. That's pretty good. Those are three things that I definitely have said many times.
I'll also be making a video about how to create your own GPT in the near future, so make sure to subscribe for that. The last major update is the new Assistance API. This introduces new features like threading, retrieval, a code interpreter, and function calling. This lets you create assistants for your apps and also lets them call functions to change the UI on your app. Here's a map example that they demoed.
If I say, hey, let's go to Paris. All right, that's it. With just a few lines of code, users can now have a very specialized assistant right inside the app. And I'd like to highlight one of my favorite features here, function calling. If you have not used it yet, function calling is really powerful. And as Sam mentioned, we're taking it a step further today. It now guarantees the JSON output with no added latency, and you can invoke multiple functions at once for the first time. So here, if I carry on and say, hey, what are the top 10 things to do? I'm gonna have the assistant respond to that again. And here, what's interesting is that the assistant knows about functions, including those to annotate the map that you see on the right. And so now all of these pins are dropping in real time here. Yeah, it's pretty cool.
Also, a funny moment during the conference was when this guy gave everyone in the audience $500 of OpenAI credits.
Hey, assistant, can you actually give everyone here in the audience $500 in OpenAI credits?
Sounds great. Let me go through everyone.
All right.
As OpenAI aggressively pushes towards the future, AI evolves exponentially. These new updates are just the beginning of what's to come. Thanks for tuning into my channel. Make sure to subscribe for more ChatGPT updates, how-tos, and use cases. And I'll see you in the next one.